Deputy Vice Chancellor Administration, Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic, Registrar, Supervisor Librarian, Provost of the College of Medicine, Deputy Provost, Dean of Science, Deans of other faculties, the postgraduate school and of students, directors of institutes and centers, heads of departments, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. The 11th in the series of University of Ibadan, inaugural lectures for the 2015-2016 session will be delivered by Professor Adekunle Igahe Christopher Odeboji of the Department of Botany on behalf of the Faculty of Science. Born on 1st July 1950 in Lagos, with the family of late Bar Samuel Adekunle and Mama Christina Wura Odeboji of Agate Compound, Awe, Adekunle Igahe Christopher Odeboji had his primary school education at Christ Baptist Day School, Awe, from 1956 to 1962, and his secondary education at Awe High School, 1963 to 1966, and Baptist Academy, Lagos, 1967 to 1968. He worked briefly with the Nigerian Security and Printing Company in Victoria Island, Lagos, before joining the Nigerian Postal Service, which he left in 1971. Thereafter, he traveled to Freeport, the Bahamas, West Indies, for higher education. He attended the Northern Virginia Community College, Alexandria, Virginia, United States of America, from 1974 to 1975, where he excelled and was on the Dean's Honors Roll. He also attended the Patrick University of America, Washington, D.C., from 1975 to 1978, where he obtained his Bachelor of Arts degree in biology. He further attended Howard University, Washington, D.C., from 1978 to 1980, where he obtained his MSc degree in botany by College of Oxford. He returned to Nigeria in January 1981 and participated under the National Youth Service Corps team at Lagos State Technical College of Job, Lagos State, between January 1981 and January 1982. Professor Odeboji had a brief stint as a biology teacher at Awori Ajirobi Grammar School, Ojojoro, Lagos, in August 1982, and later served as research officer one at the Cocoa Research Institute of Nigeria, Adia University, Ibadan, from September 1982 to June 1990. He registered for his PhD program in plant pathology in the then Department of Botany and Microbiology of this university, and later joined the academic staff as an assistant lecturer, same department, with effect from 4th July 1990. He was upgraded as lecturer to the 2 with effect from 21st November, that same year, 1990. And promoted lecturer to 1 with effect from 1st October 1994. Senior lecturer with effect from 1st October 1997. Leader with effect from 1st October 2002. And attained the Motivate accolade of a professor of me with effect from 1st October 2007. Professor Odeboji has provided several PhD student projects, over 40 MS dissertations, as well as 13 PhD thesis in plant pathology and mycology. He is currently supervising 10 PhDs. He has published over 90 scientific articles in reputable national and international. Within this university, Professor Odeboji has served very curiously in several capacities, including a top initiative as a staff manager for St. Pedro, 1st November 1993 till 31st October 1999, then awarded of the same award from 1st August 2003 to 31st July 2004. Acting as the former Department of Botany and Microbiology from 1st August 2004 to 31st July 2006. And acting head and leader of Cancer Fed, Department of Putin, from 1st November 2010, in the position that he occupies. Outside this university, Mr. Odeboji has served as personal examiner at the University of Lagos, the Federal University of Agriculture, Abeokuta, Upper Federal University of Lagos, for Lagos University, Agoyi, Vice-Chancellor of the University of Education of Jabode, Federal University of Technology, Abuja, Ekiti State University, Abuja, University of Agriculture of Makoji, Amadu Bello University of Zaria, and Osmaga Fodo University of Sikoku. He is a fellow of the Science Association of Nigeria and the trustee of the Phytopathology Society of Nigeria. Professor Deborah is an evangelist and has been ordained in the Baptist Church as a minister. He is married to Mrs. Christina Apostle Deborah and the marriage is blessed with her children. I now call on Professor Adebuyika Christopher Deborah, the head of the Department of Food, to deliver his lecture titled Integrated Plant Disease Management, the Panacea for Food Security, Professor Deborah.
Vice Chancellor, sir, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Administration, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic, the Registrar, the Librarian, Provost of the College of Medicine, Dean of the Faculty of Science, Dean of the Postgraduate School, Dean of other faculties and of students, Directors of Institutes, Distinguished Ladies and Gentlemen. To God be the glory, great things He has done in my life. For the opportunity to give this inaugural lecture in the new Department of Botany. The original Department of Botany was a foundation department of the Faculty of Science in 1948. The Department of Botany and Microbiology, which evolved from the original Department of Botany in 1982, was eventually separated into two departments, namely Botany and Microbiology in 2010. Therefore, I'm privileged to give this first inaugural lecture in the Botany since the unbundling of the Department of Botany and Microbiology in 2010. It is my desire to start this lecture by thanking and praising God Almighty through Jesus Christ our Lord for making this occasion a reality. I give glory to the omnipotent, omnipresent, and omniscient God, who has been faithful and merciful to me and my family in many ways. I thank the Creator of heaven and earth for keeping me alive to see this day. Glory be to His holy name. I pay tribute to all the professors who have delivered previous inaugural lectures in the Department of Botany and Microbiology from the university. Incidentally, they were all botanists. I must mention my supervisor, a mentor, Professor P.A. Ojo, who delivered his inaugural lecture on fungi and mankind in 1981. Professor A. Ekunyomi, who delivered his lecture on mosses and mankind in 1993. Professor O. Oshonbi, who has expanded my horizon of research in plant disease management by the use of mycorrhizae and delivered his lecture on botany beyond a conventional agriculture in 1999. Today's lecture underscores the interrelationship of botany to agriculture, for agricultural sciences and forestry. The lecture is coming 17 years since the last one from the Department of Botany and Microbiology. My area of specialization is plant pathology and mycology, with special focus on plant disease control and management. This inaugural lecture is titled Integrated Plant Disease Management, a Panacea for Food Insecurity. I've chosen this topic because of its importance to humanity and my interest in mining the ground and town in Botany. In order to bring the topic into an appropriate focus, I've decided to break it into the following sub-areas. What is botany? What is the disease in plant pathology? Integrated plant disease management? Importance of plant disease to food safety? My contribution to plant disease management? Food security? truly integrated disease management. What is botany? Botany is the study of plants and plant products, or the study of the science of plants. Botany is not just about naming plants or beautifying the environment with flowers or studying forestry. For a plant to be named, the attributes, morphology, habitat, uses, phytochemical component, anatomical characteristics, ecology, growing habitats, and other characteristics must be known. Plants play a role in every life and touch almost every aspect of human existence. In one way or the other, plants meet our essential basic needs of provision of oxygen, food, timber, drugs, fuel, shelter, clothing, and by circulation of minerals in most industries. Plants are the primary producers in the food chain. All other organisms are consumers, man inclusive. Botany has several disciplines, which include taxonomy and biosystematics, plant physiology, plant biochemistry, ecology, phycology, algology, bryology, palynology, paleobotany, ethnobotany, plant geography, horticulture, environmental botany, forensic botany, economic botany, plant breeding, plant genetics, cytology, plant pathology, and mycology. To study botany as a basic science opens one up to several career opportunities in pure and applied sciences. What is a disease in plant pathology? A plant disease can briefly be defined as any problem with a plant that causes reduction in yield and/or quality, or as an abnormal growth and/or dysfunction of a plant. It is an interference with one or more of a plant's essential physiological or biochemical system, giving rise to characteristic pathological conditions in the plant. Plant diseases can be broadly classified according to the nature of their primary causal agent, either infectious or non-infectious. Some plant diseases are caused by biotic agents such as a fungus, bacterium, mycoplasma, virus, viral, nematode, or parasitic flowering plant. The plant diseases caused by these biotic agents are termed infectious diseases. Some other plant diseases are caused by abiotic agents, such as unfavorable physiological factor, such as a deficiency of excess of temperature, soil alkalinity or acidity, disadvantageous relationship between moisture and oxygen, toxic substances in the soil or atmosphere, and an excess or deficiency of an essential mineral. The plant disease caused by these abiotic agents are termed non-infectious diseases. For a disease to occur, three conditions must be met. Firstly, a pathogen has to be present or in the plant. Secondly, there needs to be suitable environmental conditions for the pathogen to grow. Thirdly, the plant will be susceptible to the disease. The fate of any disease in a crop is determined by the interaction of the pathogen, host plant, and the ideal environment. The interaction, which is known as disease triangle, plays a critical role in determining the nature of plant disease epidemics in the course of disease management programs. Integrated plant disease management. Many attempts have been made by researchers across the globe to study the manage of plant disease. Some of the methods that have been employed in controlling various plant pathogens include physical, chemical, biological, and cultural controls. Therefore, the need for human and environmental friendly approach in controlling plant diseases has to the global acceptability and increased use of biological control in disease management. Biological control includes the use of natural defense mechanisms, mycorrhiza, antagonistic microorganisms, botanicals or biofungicides, plant extract and soil or organic amendments. Importance of plant disease to food safety. Plant diseases have caused several losses to humans in several ways. Families have been uprooted and displaced as a result of starvation due to family occasioned by huge loss of crops. The diet and eating patterns of some families and communities have been permanently altered due to similar reasons. Consequently, some communities have become dependent on imported foods, other replacing balanced diets with processed foods that cause further health problems. Plant diseases have caused catastrophes of no small measure, in which large areas of land of planted food crops were destroyed. This has led to certain countries of the world to be inadequately fed at some time in the past. Plant diseases have also been severally documented in the reduction of production and quality of food, fibers, and biofuel crops. Losses of important crops to pustular diseases, especially when farms are far from markets and or effective pustular storage facilities are not in place, have also been well documented. Many post-harvest pathogens have been reported to produce toxins that pose serious health problems to consumers. My contribution to plant disease management: use of natural defense mechanism in disease management. One of my humble contributions to integrated disease management started with a research in exploiting the biochemical defense mechanism of plants in disease control. This was carried out by evaluating the qualitative and quantitative activities of phenolic compounds of kola nut in the preservation of two varieties of edible kola nut, namely kola nitida banja ogo and kola acuminata abata, whatever in 1996. The study clearly indicated the presence of large quantities of phenolic constituents in the kola nut when compared with other fruits such as grapes, pears, apples, and oranges. The extracted phenol compounds were tested on the Postales pathogen, Botryoblongia trogonae and Fusarium palidorosum, which caused black or mummified rot and dry rot kola nut. It was found that the extracted phenol compounds inhibited both spot germination and mycelial growth of the pathogen. Odepodi and Osho, 1995-1996. This prolongs the preservation quality of kola nut in storage better than other fruits. The study revealed that as the level of the phenolic compounds of significance in the kola nut decreased, the nuts became more susceptible to storage pathogens. To maintain a minimum level of phenolic concentration required to preserve the kola nuts, the study showed that the nuts should be stored in an environment with relative humidity that would keep the nuts fresh and well protected from dryness. On evaluation of leaves used traditionally for preservation of kola nuts, it was discovered that the leaves assisted in the retention of natural botanical defense compounds at a level that would not degrade the kola nut for a period of 3 months. Akitaya 2015 investigated the interaction between soil-borne fungus, Fusarium oxysporum, FSP lycopersicum, and parasitic nematodes, Melaleuca incognita, in relation to the quantity of phenol produced in tomato Solanum lycopersicum. In response to infection, 3 cultivars of tomato Stima tolerant Pneumonata resistant and Berserker variety were studied. Their inoculated control and similar inoculation with Fusarium had the highest phenol concentration in Pneumonata at 10 days after inoculation. In the second experiment, the singular and combined inoculation had significant effects on crop yield and disease parameters. This experiment established the potency of natural defense mechanism in disease control. Biological control in disease management, mycorrhiza in disease management. Mycorrhiza colonization decreases the pathogenic effects of Salicylic disease fungi by physically excluding them from already occupied sites. Back in 1976, this information prompted us to investigate the influence of mycorrhiza in managing root rot of pepper, tomato, quality protein, maize, caused by Strigla lutea. This was done in the experiment carried out to examine the influence of arbustular mycorrhiza fungi on the disease severity of pepper and tomato caused by Sclerotia rupesi. Results show that the tomato and pepper plants inoculated with the pathogen express wilting and damping off symptoms. However, those inoculated with mycorrhizae before pathogen had significant symptom suppression, such as diaper, defoliation, leaf number, height and diameter, abortion of flowers, and fruiting. The above plant biomass of simultaneously inoculated plants was higher than the uninoculated controls of plants with mycorrhizae alone. The nutrients obtained in the mycorrhizae inoculated plant was also higher, whatever they at all, 1995-1997, when Apostolan mycorrhizae EM was used as a means of managing the root rot disease. There were two observations recorded. First, AM inoculated plants was nutritionally healthier than an uninoculated plant. In inoculated plants, phosphorus, other nutrients were made more available by AM IV than in the uninoculated plants, and former were therefore able to withstand and resist pathogenic infection better than the later. Salami 1999, whatever they at all 201, whatever they are Salami 205. Olowe, 2016, investigated the effects of Apostolan mycorrhizal fungi, Globus desarticola, and Globus flavum on air rot disease of maize, Cymase. Results show that the protection of plants against pathogenic organisms depends on the performance of their growth and new characters. The inoculation of Apostolan mycorrhizal fungi in the maize plant significantly improved their growth characters, and there was a significant reduction in narrow disease of the crop. The use of antagonistic microorganism in disease management. Antagonistic microorganism are biotic agents that either suppress or inhibit growth of another biotic agent. The activities of antagonistic microorganisms can be expressed in three major areas, simply or in combination, and these are competition, antibiosis, and hyperparasitism. My own contribution in this area was on crops such as pepper, tomato, maize, cocoa, citrus, banana, and plantain. My first research on antagonistic activities was by isolating fungal flora of pepper leaves, flowers, and fruits in the field during the planting season. This was screened against rot pathogens isolated from pepper obtained from various markets in Ibadan. Out of 29 different phylloplates, microflora isolated from leaves, flowers, and fruits of the field-growing pepper, Capsicum annuum, only Trichoderma species were promising. This Trichoderma species included T. alizianum, T. viridiae, T. pinnatiforum, and T. longifera cratum. The in vitro screening showed that the Trichoderma species had more to strong antagonistic activities on the Postalis pathogen, Rhizopus nigricans, Aspergillus niger, Penicillium citrum, and Oidium species. The mode of antagonism was by nutrient competition. Better antagonism occurred when the antagonists were inoculated 24 hours before the pathogen, whatever they are showing at 2:01. So Valet 2:05 examined the antagonistic potential of Trichoderma species resident on maize plant against the pathogen Fusarium moniliformi, now Fusarium fasciculoides, causing maize stem rot, strain of six Trichoderma species successfully controlled the pathogen both in vitro and in the field. Trichoderma asiatum strains 3 and 4, T. pseudoconigi strains 1 and 1 to 5, T. amato, T. polysporum, T. viridiae, and T. longifera cratum exhibited significantly greater endocrine capabilities than the pathogen within the maize stem tissue. In another experiment, the phytobeneficial effects of bacteria, especially Enterobacter species, were evaluated on maize seeding health and growth. Out of the 19 isolated examined, 2 were more remarkable in their phosphate solubilization efficiency, chitinase enzyme activity, and antifungal activity with little or no evidence of disease expression in maize seeding. The second isolate, OSR7 and IGGR11, were identified, and 16 SRDNA revealed both isolates as Enterobacter species. The evaluation of both isolates ascertained that their combined effects were more effective on male seedling than their individual effects. Their combination completely suppressed pathogenic activities of Xenopastimoides on male seedling with no disease symptoms. Male plants that received other treatments significantly expressed seedling disease symptoms such as leaf fall and stem rot. The combination of most treatments significantly enhanced seedling height, stem girth, leaf area, as well as nitrogen and potassium content. The phytobeneficial effect of these Echinobacter species suggested that they could be employed as bioinoculant for male seedling health and growth. Abiola and Otebode, 2015. Adeniyi et al., 2005-2006, conducted an experiment to investigate the antagonistic potential of Trichoderma species native to cocoa plant and its rhizosphere against the podworm pathogen by Trichoderma legacaya. In the result, Trichoderma aristeanum, T. iridae, T. atropiridae, and strains of T. asperellum were found to be antagonistic in vitro and in vivo against the pod rot pathogen. There was a significant reduction of the pod rot in all the cocoa varieties. Use of botanicals as biofungicide, medicinal plants. My humble contribution in biofungicide research began in 1996 when an experiment was conducted to control both the Diplodia trogomae, Aspergillus niger and A. flavus, and A. acaricius, which were implicated in the rot of citrus senescence, using leaves of Oxymum gracilissimum, Nuclear Atrophida, Senna alata, Cajonus cajana, and Arcadium occidentalis. Extract from these plants had significant fungicidal effect on the rot pathogens by inhibiting the potential at the pathogens, mycelia in liquid medium, in vitro, and also by controlling as much as 85% of rod diameter on the orange, in vitro, whatever we are changing, 201. In another experiment, the antimicrobial activities of constituents extracted from Isolona coliflora, Cleistoclami cricri, Uvaria shiveri, and Atrabotris branchipetalus were found to inhibit the mycelia of Fusarium solanae, Potrodiplodia trogomae, Aspergillus niger, and A9 flavus, isolated from deceased fruit, whatever they are taught, 2426. The constituents were found to include Clondium E and F, oxypetanoid, as well as azotogenes. In another experiment, the fruit rot and necrotic lesion on both green and tomato fruit in the pan were successfully controlled with extract of Calotropis pocera, Adasonia giganta, Manioc espumenta, Jatroba cacos, and Magnifera indica, Otaweri Chupa, 2015. Akamu et al., 2013, studied the phytofungicidal potential of aqueous extract of Magnifera indica, Jatroba cacos, on the Fusarium pathogens of millet seedlings in southwestern Nigeria. Based on the in vitro experiment, the cacos significantly inhibited the mycelial growth of Fusarium pathogens at increasing concentration better than M. indica. There was significant suppression of the effects of F. anthophyllum, F. acidinoides, F. oxysporum in vivo by extract of the cacos at different concentration. Extract of M. indica also shows significant suppression of F. acidinoides and F. strepsils at different concentration. However, both extracts significantly reduce the incidence and severity of disease caused by F. anthophyllum and F. oxysporum at different concentration compared to the control. The Fusarium species showed significant inverse relationship with disease severity, while a significant correlation existed between the extract and disease severity. Botanicals of J. cacos and L. indica were therefore considered effective against Fusarium pathogens of millet seedlings. It was then concluded that they could be employed in a large-scale farming for sustainable millet production in Nigeria. Management by organic soil amendment. Efforts were also made at using organic amendments of soil in controlling root rot disease. Our studies showed that amendments of the soil with chicken manure, wood ash, and composted neem, and osmium gracetinum leaves suppressed root rot incidence and severity of disease in pepper. In pepper plant, Oyabode and Shiru, 201. Poultry manure was also found to significantly reduce disease incidence and severity of pepper by vinegar multivirus on pepper, Panjimi and Oyabode, 206. The effect of three organic soil amendments, the cassava peel, sawdust of Gramidia odorata, and leaves of Cederella odorata, singly and in combination on the stock growth of maize caused by Fusarium fastidioides were investigated in another experiment. All the treatments at different concentrations were found to have significantly different effects on plant types, number of leaves, leaf areas, and stem grass. All treatments also had significant effects on disease in species and disease severity of the treated plants compared to control. The group weight of plants that received all treatments were also significantly higher than control plants. Control, plants treated with cassava peels combined with seed odorata had the lowest disease index and severity. It was submitted in this experiment that soil amendments can be of benefit to maize production but may be effective at different concentrations. Use of combined treatments such as cassava peel and seed odorata, which competed favorably with F. fastidioides, was also suggested as a good soil amendment method against such fungi. It was also concluded here that the severity of stock rot of maize can be reduced significantly in amended compared with an unamended soil. Abimbola 2015. Management by host resistance. Olawunye 2013A investigated the tolerance or susceptibility of four different genotypes of quality protein maize to Striga lutea. Striga lutea is a parasitic plant. Infestation. The results show that ART98SW5OB and ART98SW6OB were highly tolerant, with ART98SW4OB being moderately tolerant and EAOB being highly susceptible. Phenotypic coefficient of variance was higher than genotypic coefficient of variance for tasseling length, stem diameter, and ox cover. The first, second, and third PCA recorded 38%, 25%, 23% respectively in three environments examined. It was therefore submitted that cultivars with broad-based tolerance to Striga lutea can be developed from ART98SW5OB and ART98SW6OB. Disease management by integration. Our observation showed that better management and control of disease was achieved when two or more management efforts were adopted. The combined impact of histological and anatomical structure of Discoria alata, Wataya Emura, on its resistance to anthracnose disease caused by Colletotrichum blospharoides pens in three agroecological zones in Nigeria was evaluated in another experiment. The study showed differences between the morphological structures of leaves of resistant and susceptible genotypes. The susceptible genotypes had more numerous stomata on lower epidermal surface and thinner cuticle through which the pathogen could penetrate into the plant cell easily. The cuticle of the resistant genotype was thicker than the susceptible ones. Results in this experiment suggested that resistance in E. alata could be attributed to inability of cyclosporoides to easily penetrate the thick cuticle. Two band races, DTA-289 and DDA-294, showed the highest level of resistance out of the 23 genotypes evaluated. The result of 10 years, which was due to combination of histological and anatomical makeup of the young genotype, further underscore the importance of integrated disease management. Olawunye 2021 and 2011 conducted an experiment to examine the effects of combined treatments, namely genotype resistance and influence of AFM on strider emergence in maize. The AMF in the treatment combination included Globus clarum, G. desaticola, G. mosae, and G. giganta. G. globus clarum was found to significantly reduce the strider emergence and strider damage rate. This ultimately increased plant height and grain yield in ART98SW5OB. Salami et al. 2-1 examined the interaction of Apostolar mycorrhizal fungus with the pathogen Phytophthora infestans and antagonistic Trichoderma species on growth of pepper castricum annum. In the result, pepper seedlings simultaneously inoculated with the three microorganisms had good growth parameters such as early and high flowering incidence, fruit maturity, an increase in leaf number, plant height and growth. However, the effect of the pathogen was highly suppressed in the treatment. The significance of the study was that the interactive effects of the antagonistic microorganism and mycorrhizal prevented the disease severity and stimulated plant growth. This also underscored the critical role of integrated approaches in disease management. Otherwise, and Shewu, 2-1, investigated the effects of different treatment combination on incidence and severity of root rot of disease of pepper, capsicum annum, the plantage and soil amendment with chicken manure, wood ash, and namely, were found to suppress damage and found to suppress the disease to a significant extent in the plant. Adetiji et al. 2010 examined the ability of certain microorganisms with promising antagonistic potential to withstand common fungicide used in controlling Phytophthora pod growth of cocoa, but in vitro and in the field, foragam OH, regular gold, and copper sulfate were found to be significantly tolerated by different strains of Trichoderma asterenum, which were abundant in cocoa ecological zone. These Trichoderma strains were found to be non-pathogenic to cocoa, but were able to colonize and persist in the cocoa pod, effectively controlling Phytophthora pod growth. They were therefore recommended as a biopesticide and integrated pest management component for sustainable control of cocoa loss in cocoa vines. Adeleji examined in comparative in the same experiment, examined the comparative efficacy and economic viability of Trichoderma strains or spout control agents for the control of Phytophthora rot pod of cocoa in Nigeria. All the biogens significantly reduced the percentage pod rot of peel on the peel. The highest mean pod rot incidence among the treated pods was significantly lower than the control. The highest revenue cost ratio was obtained from copper sulfate treated plots, while the least revenue cost ratio was obtained from regular gold plus T asterenum strain 3 treated plots. T asterenum strain 4 was found to perform better than other allergens. Most of the other treatments, when applied simply, resulted to 25% comparative efficacy and economic viability. These bioagents were successfully combined with fungicide, thereby reducing the frequency of fungicide application from 4 to 1 with significant pod rot reduction in the field. A comparative higher yield and more profit revenue cost ratio were also recorded. Food security to integrated disease management. Food security can generally be said to be a combination of adequate food availability and food access. It was once defined as when all people at all times have physical and economical access to sufficient, safe, and nutritious food to meet their dietary needs and food preferences for an active and healthy life. Food security is an important issue considered to be a responsibility of all stakeholders. Plant diseases and plant pests and diseases are generally known to pose major threats to food safety and security. They are known to reduce production and quality of food, fiber and buffer crops. Their effects can be more catastrophic when farms are a long way from markets with very poor infrastructure and supply chain practices. Both field and post-harvest disease have been reported to cause huge losses of different crops at different times, in history. Such devastation by plant diseases, which had caused famine at one time or the other in certain parts of the world, can be far-reaching in its effect on food security. In the past, millions of people have been reported to die of starvation as a result of the devastating effects of plant diseases on yields of staple crops. Millions have also been reported to emigrate from their countries for similar reasons. Presently, the threat posed by plant diseases to food security is particularly great in developing countries where poverty is endemic and populations are growing at an alarming rate, with the same population depending solely on locally produced staples. Food security is not only defined by availability of crops, but also by their safety level. It also means that all agro products, as much as possible, should be free from pesticide residues. There have been reports of crops with different pesticide residues posing dangers to consumers. Many pathogens, especially phosphates, are also known to produce toxins in several crops, thereby compromising the safety status of such crops. This has created very serious health problems for consumers, men and livestock alike. The potential of a single control method to significantly reduce pests or disease population has been reported to be minimal. No single disease control method can thus be said to guarantee food security and safety. Farmers worldwide in times past had spent billions of dollars on single disease management, which aimed at improving food security by reducing crop losses. However, this was often with the resultant food safety not commensurate with such a huge spending. Therefore, integrated disease management approach holds the most effective promise in that it combines all the available disease control methods by the most economical means with the minimal possible hazard to life and the environment. Though a lot still needs to be done with regard to global food security, it could be said that the world would have faced a crisis of untold global food shortage if plant disease were not tackled headlong through the use of integrated disease control measures. This is because, in the course of IDA, all aspects of crop and farm management are closely monitored. In the primary concern of every aspect, indeed, the primary concern of every aspect of IDA is food security and safety. Agriculture, in whatever form, in any form of the world, aims to provide food security. It has been reported that global food production must increase by 50% to meet projected demand of the world population by 2050. This goal may be achieved if crop diseases are not tackled using an integrated management approach. Concluding remarks and recommendation. Mr. Vice President, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I have in the past couple of minutes tried to discuss the importance of plant disease management by non-chemical methods and how these methods, by integration, can increase food production and food safety, which will reduce hunger in our nation. These research activities have been central to my sojourn in this university. I've examined the concept of plant disease and integrated plant disease management by way of discussing the research efforts on how to reduce pathogen damage on our crops, which may be a better option for food safety and security. I've been able to demonstrate by research that these non-chemical approaches to disease control are effective, cheaper, and feasible if they can be annexed. Mr. Vice President, sir, I hereby make the following recommendation: that we should develop a curriculum in phytomedicine just as we have for veterinary medicine and human medicine. This can be a 5-year joint program which may be housed in the Faculty of Agriculture. The program will be basically on plant health. The program will be basically on plant health. Secondly, we should find a way whereby our agricultural extension officers will be more equipped with practical IBM procedures and more alert to their duty of disseminating research findings on plant health to farmers. Thirdly, the government should set up a team to deliberate on how the research findings on the non-chemical methods of plant disease management can be utilized, such as setting up companies for commercial production of mycorrhizal inoculants and formulated powders. Other antagonistic microorganisms such as Trichoderma, bacteria, etc. can also be constituted into phytofungicide to be commercially produced for powders. More funds should be made available for research in basic science such as botany, zoology, microbiology, chemistry, physics and mathematics, which are the bedrock of applied sciences. Knowing that most of the Nobel Prizes in medicine and engineering are won by researchers from basic sciences, the government should look for a way of establishing a synergy between the Federal Agricultural Research Institute and the university for effective collaboration in their research activities to promote better food security in the country. Hopefully, this will also reduce wastefulness in research spending, rancor that occurs in appointment of executive directors, as well as rivalry and disparity among research institutes and the universities. Finally, the government should, as a matter of priority, provide an enabling environment to do research in terms of equipment, grants and power, mean electricity. This investment will produce quality research output from our university. First and foremost, all appreciation and thanks are due to God, the Father of Light, the Creator of the ends of the earth, the Holy One of Israel, my sufficiency, whose sufficient grace has upheld me from birth till today. In Him I live, walk, and do all things in His strength. Glory, honor, and adoration be to His holy name. What I am today is a product of cumulative efforts of so many people who have played one role or the other in my life. My parents are first in this category. My father, Pastor Maladik Jodebode, of blessed memory, who though was not educated, taught it fit to give all his children education. He was one among his friends at that time to make his children attend secondary school. I thank God for his life and sacrifice. My mother, Christiana Murola Adoni Odebode, of blessed memory, I cannot gloss over her role in my life. As a mother, she did everything for me. She cooperated with my father totally in ensuring that I got educated when the resources were scarce. She provided for me to continue beyond secondary school. I also thank God for the life of my stepmother, late Mama General Adito Odebode, of blessed memory, for being there for us all the time. My special gratitude to my mentors, starting from my doctoral supervisor, UCRC Tech, and academic father, Professor Benjamin Apolabi Osho, who made it possible for me to come to this academy of learning when it became necessary to continue my academic pursuit after my return from the United States of America. He was willing to supervise my PhD thesis. I thank you, sir. Professor Oluwole Oshodubi, who explained, is also here sitting, who expanded my area of research in introducing me to the world of mycorrhiza as biofertilizer and effectiveness in disease management, from which my first PhD student, now a professor, wrote a PhD. I thank Professor Adeyemi Ebunyemi, who facilitated my appointment to the Department of Botany and Microbiology. I appreciate you, sir. Your children and grandchildren shall be grateful in life. I thank Professor Ayo Fashini for the encouragement, spiritual upliftment, and joint prayers in those days when things were so wrong. to all my colleagues in the department and in the point department of botany and microbiology, Professor Esther Ogunba, Ayi Soni, Eyolunde, Eyo Bagade, Dr. So, Ojojobi, Adamsi, Pashaye, Sherifa Wakil, and Dr. Ogunbanwo, thank you for your support and cooperation. The academic staff in the Department of Botany, Professor A. Anipede, S. D. Jonathan, Dr. West, O.J. Uyetuti, Jayola, Tani Pashola, Onyikosola, Dini Petu, K.S. Chukuka, A.M.C. Salai, I. Akeshoye, Dad, Baramoshi, A. Shoko Ale, O.J. Olawi, Okokola, and O.J. Kepu. I thank you for the support I received at the end of the new Department of Botany. Your call in one way or the other contributed to the success of today. Your own day of glory shall come. I salute all the non-teaching staff of the department for their contribution to the success of today, as well as their active roles in the progress of the department. I cannot forget the academic staff of Phytopathology Unit of the Department of Crop Protection and Environmental Biology, Professor Tony Kotun, E.J. Eko, B. Powole, and G.I. Atiri, who sharpened my knowledge in plant pathology by my participation in the supervisory committee of their PhD students. I appreciate you, and indeed, you have contributed in no small measure to the success of today. I acknowledge Professor Aiki Farai, the former dean of the Faculty of Science, and the current dean, Professor Eyomi Ude, for their immense support and encouragement. I thank members of Faculty of Science for their support and leadership and mentoring roles of all our senior colleagues. Those that are still in service and those that have left, notably Professor M. A. Shomumi, A. A. Adeshomoju, O. Ekundayo, A. Roderibe, A. T. Asan, O. Oladino, L. Hussein, and O. Iruweko. I appreciate the friendship and brotherhood of Professor and Dr. Mrs. F. A. Dawu, Professor and Mrs. G. O. Adeoye, Professor Deji Ayumai, Professor O. Molonkola, Dr. J. K. Motoyola, Ajala Yogun, and other forum members, University of Peabody. To my past and present postgraduate students who passed through my supervision, you have all shown that learning is reciprocal. You have all contributed in a great way to make today a reality. I therefore acknowledge Professor Lushola Salami, OAU, Professor S. Mohamed, Professor K. Shemo, both of Usman Dampodio University, Sokoto, Drs. A. Shoko Ale, Jide Odu, Puye Kadra, Mega Botupe, A. Fajimi, Shola Odedara, A. Adebeshi, A. Adebeji, Oje Olawuyi, M. A. Abiala, M. Sika, and the latest, Maya Wamowe, M. Sulaiman, and Messrs. O. Kukola, O. A. Akamu, P. Etawiri, P. Odewale, Ms. Toyo Sakitayo, and Ms. Jumoke, Abipola, and many others. I'm indeed grateful to the following botanical assistants for this inaugural lecture: Professor Rebera G. Oyelade, Dr. C. Shoko Ale, Ojo Olawuyi, Ewo Dada, and Oluwayowa Olowe. For spiritual edification, I would like to appreciate my spiritual fathers, Bishop John Adeleko Oluwade Osho of Gospel White House of Mission, Evangelist Odunale Iyola of Messiah's Coming Ministry, Reverend Dr. and Dr. Mrs. Emmanuel Oyeko, Pastor at Federal Baptist Church, Reverend Shaman Oshola Awolabi, Pastor New Baptist Church, Reverend Israel Adetuki Apolabi, Reverend Dele Rua Okola, and all the members of Federal Baptist Church, Agbowo, Emmanuel Baptist Church, Maria, and New Baptist Church, Oluyole Extension, Ibadan. I appreciate all my neighbors where I live, Providence Close, Oluyole Extension, Ibadan. You have provided a conducive environment to live that brings peace for one to do academic work at home. I thank you for your labor leaders. I thank my sister-in-law, Mrs. B. O. John, for assistance to my family at all times. All my cousins, the Bamiduros, especially Dr. Femi Bamiduro and Yemi Bamiduro, warrant officer retired, warrant officer too retired. I thank you for your brotherhood at all times. I must thank in a special way my brothers and sisters in the Odebade family for the various ways they have impacted my life. They are Pariye Odebade, Yasite, Odori Ebi, Mrs. Gomi Alabi, Mr. Akemoba Odebade, and Mrs. Comfort Bukola, to all who encouraged me to keep on going, I appreciate you for contribution to my life. I cannot but appreciate my nuclear family members, beginning with my wife, partner and companion of these decades. To a bunch of you, I think that the only woman in my life, you are putting yourself as a wife of major character, with your unflinching and undying love and support for me. My coming to the University of Ibadan is one of the testimonies of your support and devotion. Thank you. My special students, Adefunke, Adelimika, and Adeshope, you have all given me privilege to be grateful to God. Your days of glory will surely come, and you will be greater than me in Jesus' name. Amen. Finally, it's a question. No man can receive anything except it is given from above. Therefore, to God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I give my mother praise. Come thou upon Even though the Lord has helped me, Ebenezer, I thank you all.